My name is Brandon Bowes. I'm fighting out of Leesburg, North Carolina, with Yanceyville Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Gracie Baja Mebane, North Carolina. My training camp's gone really good. Train hard so the fight's easy. No injuries, thankfully, so I feel like I'm 100% ready to go for this fight. I think it's going to be great. You know, I heard they do really good things for their fighters. You know, they have a nice setup, always sell out. And I just heard, you know, they're really cool guys up here, so looking forward to fighting for them. I see the fight ending either by decision or submission in the first or second round. It's either going to go all the way or I'm going to put them out. This is going to be one of the two.
My name is Walker Vivian. I'm fighting out of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, out of Team Side Effect. My record 6-5, and what you'll be seeing tonight is an experienced pace fight. I'm going to put the pressure, and you'll see some fireworks, that's for sure. He's an experienced guy, and I'm experienced, and we're coming in here to give a good show.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout, 3 3-minute rounds in the 170-pound welterweight division. Introducing first the fighter on my right, fighting out of the Appalachian Auto Works blue corner, fighting for Yanceyville Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu of Leesburg, Virginia, coming in with a record of 5 wins and 2 losses, Brandon Bowes. And his opponent, the fighter to my left, fighting out of the National Guard, red corner, representing Hilson Gracie Academy of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, coming in with a record of 6 wins, 5 losses, Walker the Kid Vivian. The referee, Wayne Spinola.
Undoubtedly, these are the two most experienced guys on the card fighting here tonight.
Got a feeling Walker's going to come out kicking. Just a hunch.
Maybe his tattoos give his legs more power.
Oh, he's coming out punching. It's only a matter of time. You'll see that Muay Thai come out in him. He is really good Muay Thai.
Oh, actually, Brandon throws the first kick there. Checked by Walker. He looks intent to set the pace with the jab here.
There goes
big
the first
kick. Corner calling for a lot of jabs from Walker Vivian. Big power right.
There's one thing I can say about Walker. He is a little power plant.
He looks like he's built to throw hard. Hit hard. And
that's a nice one.
Yeah, Bowes is keeping that right hand up a little bit higher after eating one of those.
Walker looks really fast, really smooth right now.
Yeah, really, really composed here. Oh, that turned Bowes around here. He did not like that kick. He is heavily planted on that front leg, if you notice. And he's got a very flat-footed footwork, so he's going to have a lot of weight. And those leg kicks are going to hurt more than if he was on the balls of his feet.
In my opinion, Walker's probably the best fighter on the card as far as experience.
And technique. Definitely the most experienced fighter on the card. He is throwing power
he
shots
has got
at will
some
here.
Haymakers going. This you looks know, like an undisputed
team. Popped him in the ear. Oh, Walker is all over him, swarming right now. Bowes is amazingly composed to be getting hit so much, but that looks like his complacency is playing
Walker
against him.
Walker Vivian looks like a man possessed.
Big, big knee to the liver. Did you see the separation there?
Yes.
And another one.
It looks like Brandon might tap. He doesn't really look like he wants to be in there.
You know, I'm going to have to agree with you. He's taking some serious punishment, but he does not look worse for wear. So a lot of heart here from Brandon Bowes. And now you got to wonder if Walker maybe didn't gas himself out just a little bit.
I don't know. Walker's he's like a little Energizer Bunny.
He's slowing down just a wee bit here. He's probably trying to gather himself a little bit, and that's good for both of them because Brandon definitely ate some big, big shots there.
Yeah.
As you said, Walker puts everything into every shot. A lot of power coming from this guy.
That's a nice little shot from Walker on that one.
Definitely. That round has to go to Walker. Big power shots landed. I'm really impressed with his technical striking here with the kicks, mixing the hands and the kicks up. And that knee to the liver on Boza against the cage just looks brutal.
Also considered a premier diamond buyer. Contact Mobile Gold at 808-442-9588. Also, do you got a knack for singing? The Slump Star kicks off on April 2013. The grand prize, $1,000 at Cole.
I got to wonder what the strategy change for Bose is here. He can't come out the same way as last round. He needs to probably be more aggressive and put the pressure on Walker. Or try to get the fight to the ground with some hands. He does not want to be in Walker's way.
Walker's corner is basically telling him he needs to come out like a bull in a china shop, barraging with everything he's got again. And maybe this time, it might end it in this round. But everything happens crazy in a cage.
Brandon's got to throw something back. He's getting walked down right now. Walker's landing at will.
And he's just stalking him right now.
Yeah, Bose needs to put the pressure on, do something here. He cannot just walk backwards and let Walker tag him as he pleases. See, for some reason, he looks like he's waiting for a Walker to throw to try and counter, but he's not countering. He's eating these shots.
Like Walker's corner still ordering for more jabs. And now
big right hand connects.
Nice knee to the.
What about Brandon Bowe's chin? He is a tough customer here.
Some more. There's another barrage.
I am hearing that. I am hearing every shot here. Walker throws his pop right in front of me. I feel like I'm getting punched.
Especially since we can hear him like we're standing next to him.
Brandon's starting to look a little worse for wear here. He is taking some big punches from Walker.
Yeah, his face is starting to bleed in a little bit. Well, not a little bit, kind of moderately a lot.
Not really sure where it's coming from. He doesn't appear to be cut. It looks maybe like it's coming from the nose and it's spread out across his face here. But he's not intimidated. He's not intimidated by the power of Walker. He is he's still walking right in there.
Just looks for me like Walker comes out for a little while, gives you his quick barrage, and then he kind of runs a little low on energy.
Definitely.
Saves up for hard, precise strikes.
Yeah, definitely. He's definitely a power fighter. He's bullying Bose around here.
I mean, that kick didn't even bend his knee.
Well, look at the legs on Walker. Those are some kicking legs. He looks like a thoroughbred horse from the waist down. Oh, chopping leg kick from Walker here. Bose tries to retaliate with one of his own, but it's just... Bose seems to be lacking in the power department. His technique is not bad. He's just not as explosive as Walker. Walker is dominating this fight so far with precise striking, power striking, and a mean jab.
Yeah. He's got a pretty precise jab the way that he's shooting it, too.
All night long, hanging out right here at the Swamp Fox. Get your drink on, get your dance on. Going down to after party right here. Check us out directly following the fights.
You know, I gotta be thinking, Brandon's corner has to be telling him right now, get up, put the pressure on Walker. He's gassed himself a little bit. He's definitely thrown a lot more strikes with a lot more power, expended a lot more energy. And if I'm in Brandon's corner, I'm definitely saying, put the pressure on, walk him down. Put him up against the cage and land your own power shots. Walker does appear to be breathing pretty hard here.
And in his corner's also got to say that you're down.
Check a kick.
You're down two rounds. I mean, you're gonna have to show a lot.
Nah, he's gonna have to. He has to look for a finish here, a submission or a knockout.
I mean, I've seen crazier things from commissions about crazier decisions, but this one's kind of one in.
That's true. But I feel like we actually have a pretty good one sitting with us here. He's a very intelligent judge here.
Nice. Nice shot. The only thing I'm kind of I kind of like Walker's composure and stuff like that from being a South Carolina fighter, where head kicks are allowed. A lot of fighters, when they transition to a different state, different rules, sometimes it might
definitely. He looked
slip.
Like he wanted to throw a few, but you know, he's abiding by the rules here, and that's like you said, that is hard to transition from state to state with the different rules.
Because for the most part, Walker's fought in the state of South Carolina, so.
You know, I can only imagine how brutal this would have been with head kicks.
It'd have been over in the first round.
Most, I'll agree with that. Oh, Brandon.
Ooh. It's nice haymaker he's bringing around there.
Yeah, Brandon's going to have to put it on. He's going to need to go low and land an overhand of his right because Walker's not moving his head coming in. If Brandon were to duck under and throw his own overhand right, it would connect. And that, oh.
Ooh. And I'm just wondering if the last outcome of Walker's fight down in Columbia, I wonder if that's kind of his driving force behind this performance. Nice
takedown. Nice takedown. Very nice. Scoring points, but he's got to finish. I think he knows it.
He's got him out. He's got his back.
Oh, and well, he slips over. Back. Slips over.
They're right in front of Walker Vivian's corner, so.
You know, I can see that being an advantage and a disadvantage as your opponent can hear everything your corner's telling you to do. Go for an arm bar. He will defend that arm bar. That's why at Alter Ego we have code words. I will not say them on the air in case I ever have to corner somebody here.
Yeah.
Plus, I know you'd tell everybody, you douche.
I would. Referee stands him up.
I mean, that's sort of in Bo's favor, but he looked way better on the ground, absorbing a lot less damage on the ground.
Yeah, I think
Walker looks a little tired here, but like I said, Bo's has got it. There was the overhand I was talking about, but he didn't put anything on it.
I think Bo's game plan could have been a little bit better, going maybe to the ground a little bit more. Looks like that might be Walker's kryptonite as of the present moment.
Or it just might be the safest place to be, as Walker has knocked the crap out of him several times. Big power shots.
I mean, I'm surprised that Bo's, he's got one granite chin. He's taken a lot of shots.
He is, and he's just driven. He has not stopped. He'll eat a big shot and come back the exact same. Dude has a lot of heart. I mean, still walking him down after eating all these leg kicks. Brandon is one driven guy. He's like Rocky right now.
Ducked under, nice little takedown.
Now, if he could like slide his leg over, he has an arm bar there, but it's...
And it's all over now.
Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind that Walker is taking this fight home with him. Very impressive fight turned in from him. I actually thought he was going to put Bose away several times in the first two rounds. Caught him clean, caught him hard.
Bose showed a lot of heart, a lot of determination. I'm really impressed by him.
I cannot disagree with you there. He took some heavy, heavy shots, got right back up, right back in the center of the cage, started throwing his hands again.
both fighters go the distance. After three hard-fought rounds, the judges have rendered their decision, all three judges, for this fight. 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision, Walker Duncan Vivian.
Very, very impressive performance turned in by Walker Vivian. Incredible technical striking.
Walker, come on back.
Fuck you saying, bro? Cause I'm a black man in the phantom. Or is it cause my window's tinted? Car cost $300,000 and I blow Enzo in it. You mad cause you thought of fucking me on spring break? Well, I'm gonna fuck with you on spring break.
Hey, man. Walker, come on back, bro. Come on back. Hey, you can't have... Yeah, put that t-shirt on. Represent. Now, you can't have a dominant victory like that and not get an interview. That's what I say about that, guys. All right, Walker, come on over here, my friend. Congratulations on the win. Now, I put you at 7-5. 12 fights you've done this thing, man. You dominated tonight. You had a great fight. Let's talk about the fight a little bit. Talk about your opponent and how this one went down.
Yeah, you know, every fight's a little different. I didn't know much about this guy, other than he was a grappler. You know, the same day weighing here in North Carolina kind of messed my cardio a little bit. But other than that, man, yeah, 12 fights. Next time, we'll see you pro.
Well, there's a big announcement right there. Hey, talk about your gym. You guys have represented tonight. Two big wins in a row. Talk about the Helson Gracie Academy. You guys come out here and you're making a real good showing here at the Swamp Fox.
Yeah, we train real hard at Helson Gracie Myrtle Beach. It's the home of Team Side Effect. We believe in it. We believe in our coach, Joe Gizzy. We believe in our team. And we believe in the program that he set up for us. So that's why we come out here and dominate.
All right, now you've already announced that you are going pro. Do you have anything lined up yet? Do you have a fight lined up in any organization?
Not yet. Nothing's 100%. But possibly back in Myrtle Beach for Warfare.
It'd be a good one to see. Also, is there anybody you want to thank before we get you out of here, bro?
I want to thank all my friends and family that came out here and my team. And I want to thank God. God named all of you to be here. Now let me thank my future wife, Jess, for coming all the way up here. Thank you.
There we go.